Hi, I'm John Hodges, HR business partner for Employment Group, and today the facilitator for the Delivery Directorates Conference.
Future. And I want to put it this way, if you think about it, we're doing something which is, in business terms, a bit paradoxical at the moment. We are very deliberately making our suppliers.
There's a feeling of mixed emotions, actually. For example, I'll be leaving Job Centre Plus after some 30 years in the organisation and its predecessors. I'll be moving to an organisation that doesn't regard the wearing of ties as obligatory. But I think more importantly, I'll be...
Well, good morning, everybody. I'm really sorry I can't be with you today. When you see these "sorry I can't be with you" messages on television, they're often recorded by the side of swimming pools in Los Angeles. Sadly, I'm just on the ground floor of Caxton House. I've just got a simple message today, which is that you've got so much to be proud of. Each week I read Alan's messages to you. I love the way he does it. I love his simple, personal, direct approach. And he gives you an honest account of what's working and what's not working. But in those messages, I've seen so much about what you've achieved. Flexible New Deal, for example, launched earlier this month.
Well, many folk here in this room have worked with him in the past. More to a point, he knows us very well, which I think is why I'm particularly pleased he's with us. He knows our world. He's every day dealing with the issues to do with performance.
Special measures for 18 to 24-year-olds. We weren't having the debate about whether if you were black, your chances of employment in a recession were spectacularly poorer than if you were white.
And do you think levels 1, 2, and 3 of devolution can be made to work for your customers in London? Or another way of asking it is, what would good devolution look like for your customers in London?
I think it would be quite good to change the language, because level 1, 2, and 3, the way it was described in the original white paper, that was a very neat kind of typography, made a nice little boxed bits. You know, white papers these days don't have reams of text, they have photos and boxed bits with bullet points in, don't they? And somebody did a neat job there. The problem is that it was written in language that nobody really understood apart from the author, I suspect. So that you start to have to carry around a little piece of paper. And remember, level one is X, level two, you know, to explain it. I think we need to find a different sort of language. And I think we should probably avoid the kind of model which almost describes an escalator, because that's what people thought. Ooh, well, we're entitled to level one, whatever that means. And then if we're good, we'll get level two. And then, you know, it's like gold, silver, bronze. You kind of, your performance pushes. And actually, that wasn't the point. I don't think it ever was.
We're going to mention it later. It's in the envelope.
So, this is the Respecting People certificate. The nominations in no particular order are Brenda McLean, Darren Rhodes, and John N. Franklin. And the winner is Darren Rhodes.
Andy couldn't give his video address from Los Angeles.
Andy's on holiday with Adam Sharples today. He actually didn't pick it up on his behalf, but he says he loves you all and thank you.